Racing to get containment lines around the Ponderosa fire. This fire now threatens thousands of homes.
In the next 48 hours, we're going to have hot, dry winds in this area that are going to cause a lot of problems for us.
The Ponderosa fire has grown to 15,000 acres. It is just 5% contained, and there are new evacuation orders tonight.
That's right. The fire is burning right near Shingleton and Viola, right off Ponderosa Way, southeast of Manton and Tehama and Shasta counties. And as thousands evacuate today, neighbors are concerned about what's next.
These are the conditions firefighters are dealing with. Erratic flames getting worse this afternoon as winds shift direction.
This is a lot of dead fuel in here, a lot of heavy fuel. It's going to be tough.
The Ponderosa fire is burning in a heavily wooded area, and it's steep, tough terrain for fire crews. They're working hard to get those containment lines in ASAP.
We've got what we call an alignment. Winds are blowing up those canyons and those draws and drainages and causing a lot of problems for the firefighters.
That's our biggest concern, is if it shifts and comes this way and losing everything we have.
Brad Kane hasn't been told to evacuate his home in Manton yet, but his family is ready.
We've got a bunch of the laundry all set up, ready to go, some paperwork and the animals. Mm-hmm. And that's pretty much all that's going to leave with us if we have to go.
Seven homes have already been destroyed, thousands forced to evacuate, and dozens of roads are closed.
Well, that's a bummer.
Now, some 3,500 homes, schools, and electrical sources are threatened from this lightning-struck fire burning since Saturday. Firefighters say these are the kind of conditions they'll face until early November.
We've had a lot of active fire in July. Here we are in mid-August, and we've got a long ways to go.